Hello everyone, welcome you back to my YouTube channel Mechanical Mantra. In this video we will be seeing the detailed analysis of frontal impact, side impact, rear impact and torsional analysis. So stay tuned. So beginning with the frontal impact, first of all we go to static structural, double click on static structural. We will first of all change the name because I am going to show you all the impact tests in the same module. So to avoid confusion we change the name. So as you know, the material which is available in Go-kart is not directly available over here. So to change the material we first of all go to engineering data. In engineering data, go to engineering data sources. In engineering data sources, go exactly over here, say click here to add new library. First of all add a new library, that is material 10. This is the new library and press the enter button. A window will pop up which will ask you the destination where you have to save the material. So I am saving it as material 10 and you can also change the location from here, say save, and your library will be changed. To add a material, say AISI 1020, which I am using for demonstration purpose, click enter. Once you click enter, you can also enter the properties which you required. I am clicking for density, isotropic elasticity. You can also add whatever property you required, extra properties you required, and these properties are easily available on internet. To change the property, click on this yellow box and a table will appear over here. In this, the property of AISI is 1860. Hit the enter button and please keep a keen eye on this unit. This unit, you can also change this units from kg, whatever you require. So the Young's modulus is 2E11. Press the enter button. Then the Poisson's ratio is 0.29. So these properties are been added, and uncheck this box and it will ask you whether to save the modified data. Say yes and the data will be added to this library. So to add this material into your library, click the plus button over here and the material will appear in your library afterwards. After that, move to project, click on the project, then go to geometry. In geometry, once geometry has been opened, move to file, go to import external file. Just remember your file should be in IGS or STP file, STP file format. So I am choosing chassis 7 IGS. Just remember while saving this file, it should be as a one body, not separate, or else it will cause problems while further analysis. So once the body has been imported over here, click the generate button and the body will be generated. This is the generated body. And as you can see, it is in single part and a single body. Once I click, the whole body will be selected. So it should be in such a format. Afterwards, I will close this and move to the folder module and going to model. In this module, we will first of all change the material. For changing the material, go to geometry. In geometry, you can see solid. Click on it, solid. By default the material given is structural steel, so we will change it to AISI 1020 and the material has been changed. The coordinate system has been fine. Mesh, you can also change the size of mesh from coarse, fine, medium. You can also change the smoothing required, but I am keeping it as a default. For generating mesh, right click on the mesh and say generate mesh. Mesh is successfully been generated. You can check the sizing going to statics. The more the number of nodes and elements, the accuracy of your mesh will be good, but I prefer keeping it as default. So Moving to static structural, first of all we have to fix the points. So I am going to the rear wheels, I am fixing the parts over here. You can also take the nodes, elements, faces, the complete body from here. I prefer keeping faces, so I kept these two faces as fixed. Then right click on the selected faces, go to name section, and in the name section put fixed, so that afterwards you will come to know. And the force will act on this frontal bumper, so I am selecting the complete faces of the frontal bumper. Just keep in mind the faces are been divided into two in FEM, so you select all the faces. Once all the faces have been selected, right click on it and go to name section. In the name section, again put the force members or just force and click OK. And you can see the name section has been appeared over here. Now to insert the name section in static structural, right click and say insert. Insert fixed support. In fixed support, go to geometric section, name section. In the name section, take say fixed and it's OK. Afterwards, static structural, insert, and go for force, and again in the geometry enter name section and select the name section on which the forces is going to act. The force is going to act in x direction, and that too in negative x direction. Here there are two options of giving the forces. One is the vector and the second is the by component. So I select by component, and I am giving 4g force. According to my calculation, it's coming 7064, and press the enter button. So this forces has been applied over here, you can see. Afterwards, go to solution. In solution, say go to deformation and total deformation. You can also add the other solutions which you require as stress, strain, energy, fatigue, etc. So you can check it over here. So afterwards, right click on the total deformation and say solve. As you can see, the model is been solved. You can check the total deformation over here. This is the unit, it is in meters. You can change the unit also in from mm, centimeter, whatever you require. So by going over here in units. So I am playing the video and showing you the total deformation while frontal impact. The maximum deformation is coming 0.038. So it's okay. This is all about frontal impact. I am closing the frontal impact. And moving further, we are going for the rear impact. For rear impact, we again require static structural. So double click on static structural, a tree will appear, enter rear and press enter. And you know, you can directly transfer the data from the earlier data. So left click on the geometry and drag it to this geometry, and it will be directly linked. So go to engineering data and just add the material in your library. This is the only thing you have to do. Now you can directly go to model, double click on model, and the model will be started. Once the model is been started, the similar procedure will follow. Go to geometry, solid, change the material from here to ANSYS. You can also see the properties over here. The mass of the chassis which has been formed, the volume, the centroid, everything you can check it over here. Then moving further to mesh, similarly I am keeping it all at default and think generate mesh. The mesh has been generated. So moving further, in this model I will fix the front two tires. So I am selecting the part of the front two tires. So right click again and say name section, and I'll give it fixed, F5XED, fixed. Okay, so in this case the forces will act on the rear bumper. So I'm checking the faces of the rear bumper, select the all faces of the rear bumper, press the control button and select all the faces one by one. just look, each and every faces has been selected. So after this, again we will apply 4G forces and all my faces have been selected. So go to create name section, and this one force is cancelled. This one face is remaining. So go to create name section, it is force. Okay, then again in static structural, insert, we'll go to fixed support. In fixed support, add the name section. In the name section, select the fixed supports, and the supports have been fixed. So again we will see, give the force members. In the force members, again give the name section. In the name section, select the force. In I'll give the component, it is in x direction, it is 7064. Enter, and you can see the forces acting over here. You can see the forces is acting over here. So again going to solution, insert, deformation, it is total deformation, and enter, solve. And this is the moment which has been generated by rear impact. So I will play the video and show you. After rear impact, the maximum displacement will be 0.03. okay, this is all about the rear impact. I will close again and move further to side impact. For side impact, again we will use static structural, give the name side impact. So again we will share the data by left clicking the geometry and sharing with this geometry. The data will be shared, and again going to engineering data and adding our required material. So moving to the project and double clicking on model. Once the model has been opened, again we will move to geometry, solid, change the material as AISI 1020, mesh, generate mesh. You can see the mesh has been generated. Now moving further, we will add the members for side impact. In side impact, we will fix the opposite members on which the force has been acting. So I am fixing the opposite faces. Right click and enter the name section as fixed. Click OK. Afterwards, select the side bumper on which the force has been acting. In case of side impact, the force will act only 2G. According to my calculations, the force coming is 3024. So all the members have been selected. Cross checking once. Okay, now right click, and giving the name post members. MBERS. Okay, so my name sections have been created. Now we will insert the fixed members by going to fixed support. In fixed support, we will select the name section. In name section, the fixed members, and our members have been fixed now. So in static structural, insert the force. In force, again we will select the name section. In the name section, the force members, and we will define it by components, and the force is acting in z direction, and it is in negative direction. So I'll give the value -3024. Okay, and now you can see the force has been acting on the side member. So moving to solutions, right click on solutions,
insert deformation and total deformation, and again right clicking, say solve. The results has been generated. So moving to total deformation, we will play the animation and see what is the effect of side impact, and the value is 0.03 meters. This will be the effect of side impact. So I'll close and move further for torsional analysis. In torsional analysis, again we require static structural. So double click on static structural and I'll just place the name. So double clicking on engineering data, I will select the material plus. Okay, so moving to project and again dragging this geometry to this, and the data has been transferred. And now double clicking on model. So again we will enter the material, solid structural ASI 1020. In mesh we'll click and say generate mesh. The mesh has been generated successfully. Now we will move to the model again, and in torsional one force will act upward and other force will act downward. So we'll have two force component in this. So fixing the rear wheels, selecting the faces, right clicking, giving the name section as fixed. So clicking OK. And now this time we'll just select the complete face from one side. So and giving it name force one. Okay, so there will be two forces acting torsionally. So again selecting the another face. In this face we'll give the name force two. So clicking OK. Then there are three name section as you can see over here. In static structural, going insert, fixed support. In fixed support we will give the name section and select the fixed members. Again we'll go to insert, give the force, select the name section, force number one. Again we'll give the component. Now you can see the force will act along the y direction. So initially I'm giving it 3024 positive, which will act upwards as you can see over here. So we will move further and give the second member, that is the force 2. In force 2 we'll again select the name section, force member 2, and component. In component we'll give now the negative 3024. There is a 2g force. So the two forces are acting opposite to each other and this will cause torsion. So moving to insert, deformation, total deformation, and right click on total deformation to solve. So this is the total deformation caused by torsion, and you can see the video, and the maximum value is 0.03 meters. So this is the end of the video. For model analysis you can check out my another video. I will provide the link in the description block. Thank you.